In this video, I'm going to explain to you how you can charge 10 times more than your competition for the same product and still make more than everybody else. So if you struggle with profit margins or aren't profitable at all, I would highly recommend sticking till the end of the video and watch the whole thing. My name is Michael Bernstein, and I've been scaling stores for the past 4 years, and I've also taught a bunch of students to do the same thing. So in this video, I'm going to reverse engineer a brand, which I'm following for a while, and show you how they pull off to sell $13 items for $300. So if that's interesting to you, stay till the end. All right, so this is the brand I'm talking about, Chris Beleni. Basically a Swedish company who do canvases. So they have a concept of taking old pictures and modernizing them. And as you can see, they have this kind of limited feel to it. So you always have 250 artworks, and if they're sold out, apparently they're not going to sell any of those anymore. So right off the bat, this company is a little bit different than regular dropshipping stores. However, it has to be your habit to analyze competitors and analyze brands, analyze successful dropshippers or successful e-commerce stores in general, because it's key to understand why they work, what commonalities they have, and which things they all do and what they have in common. So let's check out their ads. Okay, so if we check in their ad library, they have a bunch of ads running right now, and this is the very first ad I saw from them. So let's first look at it, and then we can analyze what's going on here. The very first thing you notice here is that it has a very, very cool vibe, and it's just super luxurious. Everything seems, it seems like something the coolest kid out of your high school would have this piece. So it's a very, very well-made ad, and that's what kind of makes this company really good. Again, let's watch it again. They're in a penthouse or some kind of very, very luxurious apartment. It looks very high quality. And the video itself, it's not professional. It's just like shot. It could be shot with an iPhone even. However, it has a very, very good feel to it. And all of their ads are really, really strong. So here, for example, the next one is new art just arrived. Find out where I got it by swiping up. The frame is a customer actually just shows off his cool thing he just got. This means that the frame of the ad is not, hey, I'm selling something to you, but rather, my customers are showing off. And that's really, really key. Because this fits into your Instagram feed, into your Facebook feed. It fits in very, very well next to all the videos you see regularly. Because this could be actually something your friend or a cool page would post. Just a video like this. New art arrived and like, I love it. Something like that. And again, you see like really cool art pieces. So that's the first thing. They have this frame of the buyers show off. So again, three things. Number one, it's super luxurious. Number two, people are showing off. It feels like people are showing off to this. And number three, it fits into your Instagram or Facebook feed. Also, the next thing you have to notice here is in almost every ad, they have a bunch of canvases inside of one shot. So one, two, three, four, five. Five pieces in one shot. And you're going to see this throughout their whole ad library. Again, two, here's also two. Basically, they present it in a way that you should have multiple pieces in your apartment. If you already plant the seed of buying multiple of one thing, the average order value will drastically increase. Even if you wouldn't have no upsells, no nothing, people just want multiple because they saw that it makes sense to have a bunch of them. And here, they also have this strong like influencer style videos, which basically just people showing their canvases, and again, like a bunch of them all piled up on the bed, just showing that this guy bought a couple of, like a bunch of them. And yeah, that's just very, very strong. So now let's go back to their store again and check out how the product pages of their products look. So first of all, you have the most viewed, and normally they don't link to a specific piece, but rather they link to the store. So in the ads, if you click on the ad, you're going to see the store, not a specific piece. And then again, you have this exclusive feeling to it because you only have a certain amount. To be honest, I don't really believe it. Maybe it's actually true and they really only sell 250 pieces per artwork. However, I've, for example, seen this one a lot for a while now, and they still have 85 left out of 250. I doubt that, so I don't think that's actually the case, and I think they just want to add some scarcity. But whatever the case is, it seems pretty good. What I don't like here is if you actually want to have this exclusive feel to it, there has to be a lot of products which are sold out already, because this seems like everything is available, and you can get everything. But if you would have a bunch of them which are actually not available anymore, this would trigger actual scarcity for people, and people would like believe it's real for sure. So they have something like that, and you can see it here. I think, yeah, oops, sold out art. So they have like a section for that, and I like the "and will never be restocked again" part, but it's just very invisible. Like, I couldn't see that from the first glimpse, and I also, like, most people won't click on more and then sold out art because they won't really care. But if you would actually present it off the get-go, then it would be really, really strong. So the next thing we have to notice here is the brand is based around a person. So about this Chris whatever, it's his kind of art, and they present it in a way that he is the designer and he's doing everything. I'm not 100% sure if that's actually the case. It could be just a big team. It could be actually him, but they present it in a way that it's the guy. However, they don't show his face, which is also a cool trick they do. Normally, it's really good to show a face and have like an actual person behind the brand. However, he's kind of masked, and they don't really show who the person is. The whole frame they have is that they're in between cheap posters and high-class artwork. So I was tired of choosing between cheap posters and overpriced artwork, so I found a middle ground. That's the main argument they have. And the second main argument is that they're exclusive. So many of us don't like the feeling of buying something so personal that it's mass-produced. So by doing my own original artwork and only offering my work on my website, I can bring the unique, affordable art, blah, blah, blah. So basically, they have this frame as well. Now, let's check out their prices. And their prices are very, very good. So they have three different sizes. One, $116. One is $165. And one is $330. So, first of all, I really like how they structured those pictures. And they really show how big that is. If you have this size measure, like the measurement, 1 meter times 140, first of all, if it's sold to the US, that's kind of the wrong approach. And I would also give the US sizing. But anyways, even if you live in Europe, it's not very, very clear, and you cannot like really envision how big this is. However, with those pictures, you immediately see how small or big that they are. What I don't like here is they don't have any upsells except for on the very bottom, so these things. And they also don't have any option to buy two or three pieces for a discounted price. So some kind of quantity break or something like that, just to increase average order value. I guarantee it would actually increase average order value if they would actually do it. So if we add to cart, the next thing is this thing. The next thing is that you're going to see this little upsell popping up, which I really like, and its extra protection covers loss and damages. Basically, if the package gets lost or if it gets like comes to you scratched or something like that, you get a new one, or they're going to resend it or refund you or whatever it is. But I like that they increase the average order value by basically offering a warranty. Which is very strong, and I believe that a lot of people will get this. So now again, the feeling of this product seems more than the $116 or even the $330, because it feels like it's a legit artwork. So especially if you see something like this, it looks very, very professional, especially with the frames. And they did a very good job of selling a $10 product, or like a pretty low ticket product, which I actually found on AliExpress. Basically, if you just type in canvases, you're going to see a bunch of canvases which are very, very different. Just the design is different, so the product cost is almost the same. And if you check out this one, for example, here it's going to say 140. However, those are the very small ones, so it's actually a little bit more expensive. This is just like 20 times 25 centimeters, so that's very small. But if we would even choose the biggest one, we would have a price of $12.74. So $13, they sell it for anything between 116 and 165, which is a very, very strong markup. And they can have a very high cost per purchase and be super, super profitable still just because of this. And they also don't seem like they're overpricing just because of their luxurious feel of the whole product and the ads and all of that. Especially if we check out their Instagram, it just looks very, very strong. So you can see here, every picture which is taken is connected either to a hot girl, you can see here, 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 or a super cool dude with like tattoos or a cool style, or actual influencers which like which have a bunch of followers for social proof. So this one is an MMA fighter, this one I think as well, and there's just a bunch of people who actually have big Instagram accounts, which actually gives this super strong social proof. And just by getting a couple of a little bit famous people to buy your product and to pose with your product, it can be a complete game changer to your margins and to the performance of your ads. So if we dissect this Instagram account, nothing really crazy is going on here. They have this cool mask. They have pretty either random locations with like luxury feel to it. So a cool apartment, good like expensive cars, almost like a museum looking thing, like a warehouse, a cool bar, cool apartment, tattooed guy, cool dude. Here also a good apartment, hot girl in like this seems like a hotel lobby or some kind of bathroom or whatever. But that's the reason why they can sell a $10 product for $300. And the markup purely comes from the luxurious vibe and the social proof. So nothing else is done here except for those two things. And that's why they can pull off something like that. So also a couple of things you can notice here for your own business. First of all, it's not that expensive to get good looking influencers for your business to actually make pictures or videos for your ads. If you find the right people, which they don't have to have crazy follower accounts, they can have pretty low follower accounts actually. And if you send them a picture like this, for example, if you would send them this type of artwork, if you send them to them, they would gladly make a picture of it because it actually looks really cool. So if the product quality is good, then you can send products to influencers and almost get shoutouts for free, or you pay them some money, but it shouldn't be high in the beginning. Later on, you can go for big follower counts, and then obviously it's going to be expensive, and you pay thousands and thousands of dollars, but it's super profitable anyways. Also, I've seen that you can increase the kind of value of the person or the perceived value of the person by letting them dress really, really cool. And somebody who has like 1,000 followers can seem like a super crazy celebrity by just wearing specific things. For example, a guy with a tracksuit and with like a bunch of tattoos and jewelry just seems like he is somebody. Or also with like hot girls with cool style and like a really nice apartment or some kind of cool background, perceived value just increases dramatically. So one more thing I want to touch on here is I don't like a couple of things in their upsell structure. I mentioned already the quantity breaks. However, you can see this strong, like really good looking frame here, for example. They're not selling that. They're just selling the art piece. So a frame could be a perfect upsell, which they don't have. Maybe they have a post-purchase upsell or even like an email marketing thing, but on the product page, you cannot find it. So if you cannot find it in the first like 20 seconds or 30 seconds of searching, people won't do it. Maybe they have it somewhere hidden, but I didn't see it. When I Googled it, I found a little page which links from their page to another page where you can like buy frames or whatever, something like that. But the upsell structure for the frames is really bad here. And maybe it's easier said than done, and like a huge frame is gonna be super expensive with shipping cost. However, I'm 100% sure there are solutions for that. Either even the shipping cost will pay off by having a super high price for the frame as well. Or you have like four pieces, so this will be one piece, this is second, third, and fourth, and you just have like a smaller box. So I guarantee you, if they would do those two things, so quantity breaks, and also some kind of upsell structure for the frames, the average order value would dramatically increase. And also, even though you see here like those prices, I'm pretty sure they have a good average order value. So I would guess anything between $200 and $400 is their average order value, because either somebody buys a big frame or they buy multiple of these, because they have those strong ads with a bunch of canvases next to each other, and it just seems like it makes sense to get a bunch of them. So the last thing I want to tell you is, if you see brands or e-commerce stores which are doing good right now or were doing good before, analyze them. Really try to dissect what they're doing well, why they're working, why they're not working, what they have in common, and all of that. However, keep one thing in your head. The branding aspect, or the like better looking store or whatever it is not the thing which makes the difference here. Sure, you will increase conversion and you will increase just the profitability by branding everything or by designing a really good looking store. However, that's not the thing you should be focusing on in the beginning. In the beginning, you should only focus on the product and the ads. Those two things are by far the most important. So if you select a really good product and make a really good ad to that, it will probably work. So the store and the branding is later. The store can look basic and it will still work really, really well. However, if you have a shitty ad and a really good looking store, it's probably not going to work. And the same thing goes for product. If you have a really good product but a horrible ad in a horrible store, it could potentially work because product is so important. But if the product and the ad are aligning, that's where kind of the crazy things start. So that's it for the breakdown of this brand. So I hope you got some value out of this video. If so, then subscribe to the channel and follow us for more dropshipping advice. But what's way more important than that is that you actually execute the things I told you and implement all the little tweaks and tricks I told you in this video into your business. So I hope you actually do that, and see you in the next video.